Hey everybody, it's RRPG here. It's March 21st, 2018, and welcome to RRPG Side-Quests. News within the realm of role-playing games, whether they be on the Western or Japanese front, has been very lacking as of today. And I tried to find one online before doing this, and the one that I picked out is not covering Hyperlight Drifter, which is already out on Steam and Mac, as well as the PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and even Linux, is now getting a Nintendo Switch release this summer. But believe it or not, that's not the only RPG that's coming onto the Nintendo Switch during the summertime. As we got a game that released on the PlayStation 4 as of last year, which is now coming to PC this April, and is now about to release this June on the Nintendo Switch. And of course, I'm talking about the Nintendo Switch port of VIII, Lacrimosa of Dana. Now, you all heard me cover the news bit about VIII 4 Memories of Celceta, the remake of VIII 4, which came out on the PlayStation Vita back about maybe 2 or 3 years ago, I don't know, but it came out on that platform, which is now coming to Steam this summer. And believe it or not, that game is not the only VIII game that's coming to a video game platform, as VIII 8 is also coming on the Nintendo Switch during that same time period. And I did pick up the news from Gematsu, as they had the release date to talk about for the game for both North America and Europe. The Japanese release of the game is June 28th, but believe it or not, the North American release is June 26th, whereas Europe is June 29th. So they're not too far apart from each other, so we're getting a simultaneous, an almost simultaneous worldwide release for the Nintendo Switch version for all territories coming this June. Now, on Gematsu, they not only did they talk about the release date for the game coming to all territories, but they also talked about some other tidbits, how the game is getting a Day 1 Adventurer's Edition, like how Octopath Traveler is getting a Wayfarer's Edition. But let's go ahead and see what good old Sal Romano from Gematsu had to say about VIII 8 coming to the Nintendo Switch this June. VIII 8 Lacrimosa of Dana will launch for Switch on June 26th, in North America, and June 29th in Europe, publisher NIS America announced. In Japan, a release date of June 28th was previously announced. The Switch version of the game includes the content from both the PlayStation 4 and PlayStation Vita versions. Oh, I forgot that the game also released on the PlayStation Vita. A Day 1 Adventurer's Edition will include a reversible cover, an extra foil pack of 3 character cards featuring Adol, Dana, and Dogi, as well as a double-sided poster featuring Dana and the map of the Isle of Seirin. And here's the overview of the game via Nintendo.com. Adol awakens shipwrecked, like that has happened in many Yeast games, where he ends up shipwrecked on an island and then he goes on an adventure through that island. Whereas the Oath and Fel'Ghana, I really didn't see him suffering a shipwreck in that game, as he and Dogi got to Fel'Ghana just fine. But anyway, Adol awakens shipwrecked and stranded on a cursed island. There, he and the other shipwrecked passengers he rescues from a village to challenge fearsome beasts and mysterious runes on the isolated island. Amidst this, Adol begins to dream of a mysterious blue-haired maiden living in an unknown world. Join Adol as he unravels the riddle of the cursed island and the blue-haired maiden, Dana, in VIII 8, Lacrimosa of Dana. And the key features for the game are as highlighted. An epic tale. Follow Adol and his companions on his latest adventure to uncover the mysteries of the cursed island. Another side. Unravel the mystery of the blue-haired maiden, Dana, through her own unique gameplay segments. It takes a village. Rescue your fellow shipwrecked passengers and bring them to your village, where they will provide valuable services. And party on. Switch characters on the fly as you battle ferocious foes in lightning-fast combat. Get it? Switch? Since it's coming out on Nintendo Switch. And of course, a new trailer for the Nintendo Switch version of the game just released as of recently. But anyways, yeah, so VIII 8 Lacrimosa of Dana. You never thought that a VIII game would make its way back to the Nintendo platforms after a very long time. I mean, the last original VIII game that released on a Nintendo platform, at least from my memory, was VIII 5, which was exclusive on the Super Famicom and did not get a Western release at all. I figure that, or I probably think that the next game that Nihon Falcom is working on is going to be an enhanced remake or a modern remake of VIII 5, and then it's going to release to the West for the first time. So that way, we get all the VIII games in our possession, whether they be on different platforms or whether they be on all platforms like Steam. I mean, with all the games in the VIII series that are on Steam, I mean, you got VIII Origins, then you got VIII 1 and 2 Chronicles, then you got VIII The Oath and Fel'Ghana, VIII 4 Memories of Celceta, which is coming out this summer, like I previously mentioned. We don't have Yeast 5 yet, since that game still has not got an official enhanced or modern remake. Then you have Yeast 6, The Ark of Nephishtim, which released on the PlayStation 2 and PlayStation Portable before coming onto Steam much, much later. And then you got Yeast 7, which was originally on the PSP and then came out on Steam much later. And then we have Yeast 8, Lacrimosa of Dana, which already released on the PlayStation 4 and PlayStation Vita, but is now coming to Steam, or now coming to PC next month, and then getting a Nintendo Switch version that's going to release this June. So yeah, now if Nihon Falcom or Exceed or NIS America want to release any more Yeast games on the Nintendo platforms, especially Exceed, since they really haven't put any of the Yeast games on the Nintendo platforms, not ever since they managed to localize most of the games in the 2000s. But I would say if they want to get some of those games on the Nintendo Switch, then I would say they should release some of their older remakes and older catalog of games via the Nintendo Switch eShop, so that way people can actually download those games, so that way there is no physical release for any of those games if they want to save money, because I think that would actually work if they managed to get all those games on a Nintendo platform, so that way people who have not played the Yeast games before and they own a Nintendo Switch can actually get their hands on them, you know, on that single service. So if they did that, that'd be pretty cool, but Yeast 8, just like any other Yeast game, it doesn't really follow the storyline of any of the other games, as they pretty much treat themselves as their own story, even though they do chronicle the adventures of Adol Christin and his friends, or just mainly Adol himself. But yeah, Yeast 8, Lacrimosa of Dana, like I said, it's coming out June 26th in North America, June 28th in Japan, and June 29th in Europe. So that ought to be fun to look forward to. And of course, I'm going to double dip in and pick up the PC version as well as the Nintendo Switch version. I don't know whether or not if I may get the PS4 version. I might if I decide to change my mind. And of course, we had the patch that came out not too long ago that pretty much relocalized the game for both the PlayStation 4 and the PlayStation Vita, which that relocalized patch is going to be applied for the Steam port or the Windows port as well as the Nintendo Switch. So if you were wanting to play the game in the original translation, then you're going to be out of luck. And honestly, I don't think you would want to, since the original English localization of Yeast 8 before the relocalization patch was pretty atrocious. So I think that the reception towards the relocalization has been much more positive, but NIS America really hasn't been the best, or NIS or Nipponichi Software really hasn't been the best when it comes to localizing their games, at least for the North American audiences. I mean, sure, they may have some great games like the Disgaea games, but when it comes to Yeast, I think that was a really big challenge that they had to tackle themselves. But hopefully the relocalization patch has been, you know, much more positive than what North American gamers and European gamers originally got, but we'll have to see. Anyway, let's go ahead and take a look at the comments from the last two videos that I did, since I did not cover the one from Monday in yesterday's video, so I'll be covering them both in today's video. So let's go ahead and take a look at one of the comments about Octopath Traveler. And I think it was the very first comment that I managed to catch my eye on, so let me take a look at it here. Oh yes, here it is. And this comes from SoccerFW5, and he says, or she says, "Speaking of Square Enix, what is your opinion of Kingdom Hearts 3 trailer so far?" Honestly, I can say Kingdom Hearts 3 is definitely shaping up to be, you know, a really grandiose experience. Probably even more grand than what we got from Kingdom Hearts 1 and 2, as well as the other games that came in between and after Kingdom Hearts 2. Or if you want to count the ones chronologically, I'd say that Kingdom Hearts 3 is definitely going to be the biggest and most ambitious game as of yet. Just from looking at everything, the graphics, they look just unparalleled, and it's just very spectacular with what Square Enix and Tetsuya Nomura can accomplish using Unreal Engine 4. And it's just that the combat, it looks so, so freaking good. I mean, I've not been this excited for another Kingdom Hearts game, or a Kingdom Hearts game in general, since Kingdom Hearts 2, and you saw how free-flowing that the combat was in that game, and how fast-paced it was, and just stylish it is. And this game, Kingdom Hearts 3, seems to be taking up a step even further. And it really makes me wonder, what's going to be next after Kingdom Hearts 3? I mean, how are they going to top what they're going for in Kingdom Hearts 3 when going into Kingdom Hearts 4? I mean, Tetsuya Nomura did clarify that he already has plans for Kingdom Hearts after Kingdom Hearts 3, but who knows what's going to be the future of that series. But as for Kingdom Hearts 3 itself, it's definitely looking to be a much better game. Even though it may be bigger, it definitely looks to be a more great experience when it comes to its gameplay. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the next comment, and that was from yesterday's video where I talked about the new indie RPG called, what was it called? It was called Rise of the Third Power. Yeah, that's what it is. And this is what Steve Diamond had to say. And he asked, what game is the music in background from? And that the music from that previous video that I had that was playing in the background, it actually was from The Legend of Heroes Trails of Cold Steel, the first game. And that was actually the regular enemy battle theme, or the random battle theme that you hear playing in the background. And, of course, the name of that theme is called A Glint of Cold Steel, or The Glint of Cold Steel, or something like that. But, yeah, it's a really it's a very iconic track in that game. And when it comes to Nihon Falcom, they really know how to make some really awesome music on top of the, you know, really creative and just really in-depth storylines that they have for their games when it comes to The Legend of Heroes or from Yeast. And of course, when I'm talking about Yeast today, Lacrimosa of Dana was definitely another great winner there when it comes to both awesome music as well as a really great story. But yeah, that's the name of the song that was in the previous video. And this song that I have playing in the background, that's from Yeast 8. So I just want to let you know ahead of time if you wanted to know about that. But anyway, guys, that's all I have to say about this edition of Double RPG Side Quest. And if you like what you see, then be sure to rate this video as well as leaving your feedback down in the comments. So that way, whatever comment that I choose in this video, I will actually talk about it in the next video, and then I will feature your channel in the description of that video as well. Also, if you like what you see, then be sure to hit that subscribe button underneath this video, as more support from you guys will mean that more content is coming from me in the future that you guys are not going to find anywhere else. So until next time, guys, this is Double RPG signing off by saying Godspeed. And game on, gamers. Peace out!